about 45 minutes to tell us about yourself, what you want us to know, and then we'll have our questions for you.
Okay, good, that sounds great. All right, well, it's nice to meet everybody here, and thank you for your service. Did want to say that I appreciate Melissa's service as well. I know that she had to step down, but I appreciate the time that she did spend on the board, so did want to share that, especially after her departing speech. I know that this sometimes can be a very thankless job, so I appreciate your service. So my name is Deborah Hiddle, as you guys have seen. You guys have a copy of my resume, so you know a little bit more about me than most people. I have actually been living in Chatham County as a resident for the last 12 years. I have two children, one who graduated in 2021 from Northwood High School during the major year of the pandemic. They were out of school, for most of the year. And then I also have a son who's currently attending Seaport High School as a sophomore. So my children have been involved in Chatham County Schools. They started at Perry Harrison, migrated over to Pollard Middle School, and then, of course, like my son right now is at Seaport as a sophomore. So we've been here for a while. I've had a lot of experience with the school. I've had a lot of interactions with the administration. You know, they've all been very positive, and I can't really say enough about the school district here. I think you guys have done a great job, because I know you guys, most of you, I think three of you, have been here for the last 12 years serving on the board, the whole time that my children have been in school, so right over to benefit from your leadership. So I do want to thank you for that. Again, all of my interactions have been very positive. I'm very passionate about the kids in our community. I interact a lot with sports within the community, and I've done a lot of volunteer work in and out of the schools. One of the things that I'm also really passionate about is making sure that every student and every child has a chance. And, you know, from a personal standpoint, I can tell you that for me, I was a bit of a troubled teenager, and I got into a lot of trouble. But I had a couple of, like, really good high school teachers that really believed in me. They believed in my ability to write. They believed in my ability to make. And they actually gave me a future, and I want to try to get that back to the community as well. So my sister is a school teacher in Florida. Unfortunately, I didn't get a lot of prep work for this interview because she's been pretty devastated by the hurricane that recently came through. Her school's been shut down. They're not going to be able to open until next week. Her house is underwater, so we've been dealing with a lot of personal challenges to try to get her through that so she can navigate through that. But one of the things I did want to say and just make sure that I express to you is that I believe the schools are a community. And I think, like some of you, that when you build the community around the schools, I think it makes the community bond so much stronger. And I can tell you that the dichotomy between Chapelville schools, which we had a brief experience with when we moved down here in 2009, versus the schools here. The schools here, the first thing I noticed when I moved to was they centered around the community. My children and I went to high school football games, and the first thing that I noticed was that we had, you know, farmers from the community, we had parents, we had teachers, we had, you know, plumbers, we had electricians, we had everybody in the community that came out to watch those kids play football. And I know things have changed a lot since the pandemic happened, but that's one of the things that I really love about Chatham County. And I want to make sure that I can be part of that for the schools, and you know, we give everybody an equal opportunity. Also, too, I have noticed with academia that emphasis has been very, very strongly pressed on, you know, making sure that our students are able to go directly to college. And I think that you need to make sure that there's that we provide opportunities and pathways for all students. And you guys probably saw that in the letter that I submitted to you. Your community is not just made up of four-year degree professionals. Communities are made up of plumbers and electricians, and most of these jobs are jobs that students can do directly out of high school. And I believe, too, with the new infrastructure that's coming in, one of the things that I can do as an active member within the business community is we can work with these businesses like Piper to actually start investing in our community colleges and seeing if there are opportunities for them to provide transportation from the community colleges to the high school. Like, there's just so many opportunities that I would really, really like to get involved in and embrace, because I think every child in Chatham County is going to eventually be a future and a good member of this community, and I think that the foundation starts in schools.
Thank you. And I think you might have answered part of my first question. That's okay. Two-part. Why do you want to be a school board member? And is there something in particular you want the board to accomplish?
Okay. So I want the board to accomplish equal opportunity for everybody. I do see that there is, I know that one of the things that I really appreciate is the one Chatham principles that you guys have basically established for the group. I believe in those principles. I also believe that we need to have a very diverse workforce within the school district. And the reason why I say that is because Chatham County is made up of all different types of people. And as a past student, I know that those people that you see are going to be your role models, you know, for the first several years of your life before you, you know, go out into the world and you journey on to your own, you know, adventure. And so I'm very passionate about one of the reasons why I would like to be part of the school board is I want to make sure that everybody's voice is heard and that we give equal attention to the janitors that work in our school, everybody who works. It takes a great group to, you know, to be part of a community. And as you guys can see from my resume too, I really believe in servitude leadership, and not a lot of people know what servitude leadership is. But it's when, you know, you as a manager and the people that you manage, you do what you can to make them successful. You know, whether it means that you take on a lot of their menial tasks, or you help them, or, you know, you pick things up, or, you know, you work with that, with the people within your school district, you know, to make them better. And it's the same thing with the students, too. I think that being in a position like this, you have an opportunity to basically be a servant for the community. And that's one of the things that I'm actually very passionate about.
Thank you.
Given the current makeup of the Board of Education, what would your particular set of skills bring to the table and why are they important?
All right, so obviously with the influx of jobs that we have here, we can probably anticipate, I would say, between 10 to 20 new students that will be entering the district once all these companies are up and running in the next 5 to 10 years. I have a lot of experience with new builds. I mean, as you guys can see on my resume, I've done a lot of construction and worked on projects for large pharmaceutical companies where we had to expand the site. And so I've got a very acute awareness of the challenges that come with that. And what people don't understand is that there's a lot of infrastructure challenges. And I'm sure Mr. Weiss, I think he's in here. You probably understand that as well, right? Because it's not just the fact that you've got to build a building, but there's also the services that are within the building. You know, you've got your cafeteria services. You've got your bus drivers, you've got your transportation. So there's a lot of logistical issues that have to be dealt with, and I've dealt with a lot of those in my current role and my previous roles with my employers. And I think that I could definitely help with that. Also too, one of the things that I'm really good at is looking at some of the contracts that we have, maybe some of the longer term contracts that we have with folks, and making sure that those contracts are solid. I think that one of the items that I can bring is from an operational perspective. I've actually done a lot of budget oversight, and I can look at opportunities for us to save, because if we can save on some of these contracts, then we can basically take that money and reallocate it to the places where it's needed the most. I mean, obviously we've got, you know, challenges in Chatham County. We do have some aging infrastructure, and if we can find ways to save money by challenging some of our existing contracts, or maybe combining services like, you know, financial payment systems and that type of thing, I think that there's a lot of opportunities for us to be able to save so that we can reallocate and then maybe potentially reallocate that to the teachers as well. The reward system.
I'm amazed. And you touched on several things here in my question. But what is the single most critical issue? We don't have this because we're doing such a good job. What's the single most critical issue facing the school system?
So I think the labor shortage issues is obviously a very critical issue. And you know, I'm acutely aware of that because it's not just happening in school systems, it's happening everywhere. Obviously we've got, you know, bus driver shortage, so it's not just the teacher shortage, it's the shortage throughout. And I think that the biggest challenge that Chatham County Schools has right now is that with those existing challenges, there's also going to be a lot of growth, and there's going to be a lot of new students that move into town. And I think what we have to do is, in Chatham County, is we have to make sure that our pay is competitive, right, with Wake County, because people can live in Chatham County and they can go be teachers in Wake County if they're going to be paid a little bit more money. They can live in Chatham County and they can go to places like Orange County where the pay might be a little bit more ideal for those people. So I think that as a community, one of the reasons why I feel like we should get more community involvement is because if you can understand and you can message that out to the community, then I think that they'll understand that in order for us to build a better and stronger community, we have to have strong teachers, and we have to make sure that we hire the best and brightest.
And you're right, and they come back.
Well, thank you for applying, and we appreciate your interest in the schools. And so, would you briefly describe your involvement with public schools in Chatham County or elsewhere? And what work have you already done that has prepared you for a position on the school board?
Well, in Chatham County, I've volunteered for, you know, a lot of the things that parents volunteer for, obviously field trips. I was a little bit busier when my children were younger, and I've been afforded a little bit more opportunity to do a little bit more volunteer work in the community. I've done a lot of volunteer work at the Chatham Thrift Shop to help out with the PTA, raising money. Spent a lot of time in concession stands because I have two children that were very athletic, and that's where a lot of my involvement has been, is basically within the athletics of the community. And I think athletics are very important for children too. I know people say we should really be emphasizing, and I saw that in the school board meeting, why aren't we spending more time, you know, rewarding students that do academics? And I think we do that, but I also think that sports actually provides a very healthy outlet for children, especially when you have very active children. I happen to have a very active one, which is why I've talked to the administration quite a bit for my son. But yeah, so I do believe that that's very important.
All right, last question. Will you be able to make the commitment necessary to fulfill the duties of a school board member?
Yes, I believe that I will. I'm a super avid reader. I do a lot of research. I make sure that I'm very educated before I make any decisions. I understand that, you know, I don't have past experience. I'm an educator, but I'm a very quick learner, and I tend to really dive into subjects that I may not be quite as familiar with. So I do believe that I can fulfill these responsibilities.
Okay. We've got a couple of minutes. Anything else you would like us to know?
I'm actually really shocked that we have a couple of minutes because I talk a lot and I talk very quickly, especially when I'm nervous.
Well, it's like that. You're all good. Mr. Bly says we've got about 3 left. Am I right on that? So we're good.
All right. Excellent. Well, thank you.
Thank you very much, Ms. Hill. We appreciate that.